Bihar High Court has admitted Saeed's application that seeks to quash all FIRs filed against him. In his application, Saeed alleged that the cases against him were registered under pressure from India and the US. He's also demanded that a collective verdict should be issued on all the cases against him. The combined verdict on all the cases is expected by the end of this week. The cases against the Jamaat-ul-Dawah chief were filed by the counter-terror department in Lahore and Gujranwala. These cases against Saeed were registered in July last year. A total of 23 FIRs were filed against 13 individuals belonging to the Jamaat-ul-Dawah, Lashkar-e-Toiba and Fila-e-Insaniyat Foundation. 11 of these 23 FIRs directly named Hafiz Saeed as the culprit. These FIRs said that the Jamaat-ul-Dawah was financing terrorism from the massive funds that it collected through non-profit organizations and trusts. All of the organizations are already under a ban by the counter-terror department. The ban was imposed in April last year after it was found that the organization's links were pretty much strong with the Jamaat-ul-Dawah. The Lahore High Court has now admitted Hafiz Saeed's application that seeks to quash all FIRs filed against him. But what we are looking at once again is a familiar pattern of delays. Let's get in further details now from our Pakistan Bureau Chief Anas Malik, who's now joining us live from Islamabad. Anas, tell us more about what we have been looking at as far as the court proceedings are concerned. And many would say this comes along expected lines, how we've seen the courts dragging their feet as far as the proceedings are concerned, pretty much because the government has not been able to provide the kind of evidence that was required.
Rivali, another delay on Hafiz Saeed's verdict. The two cases that have been completed and concluded at the anti-terror court in Lahore. But this delay, interestingly, comes at a time when Pakistani team is all set to depart for the Financial Action Task Force meeting in Paris. They are to depart on the 13th. Now, the court has admitted the plea of Hafiz Saeed that he had filed on 8th and said that the pending cases should be heard at first, and then all the verdict should be announced in one go. So the court has said that it would be hearing the cases today. The evidence collection was being done as we speak, and around 5 p.m. about the hearing lasted for about 6.5 hours, and around 5 p.m. is when the evidence collection was done. Now in these four cases that are left behind, the court aims at completing and ending the trial by the end of this week and announcing a verdict. Now, how the law experts understand this as, it can be a delay tactic, but then it is a rather clever move on the part of Hafiz Saeed or the administration, that since the verdict would be issued at one point of all the verdicts, therefore of all the pending cases, therefore the punishment or the conviction would be taken from that side, and therefore whatever the conviction would be in all of these cases, it would be clubbed together. That is how the law experts are looking at it. So a technical point that that has been exploited by Hafiz Saeed and his lawyers team. The cases, they continue as we speak, and the court has said, Judge Arshad Hussain Bhutta has said that they will be issuing the verdict anytime later this week. Yes, Molly.